I'm a sucker for the Sharp Auvi recorders, and when I spotted this junk auction, I had to go for it. I won it for just 370 yen, and it came with the remote, AA sidecar, earphones, bag, and a Sony stereo mic. It was listed as unconfirmed junk, so worst case, I'd get some spare parts. Immediately, you can see the battery door is stuck. There's definitely a leaky battery in there. Yep, take a look at that. Probably been sitting there for 10 years. Let's get these accessories out of the way. We've got some cleaning to do. When I'm cleaning a lot of corrosion, I like to put a paper towel underneath. Not the worst I've seen, but definitely not great. Let's plug it in and see if it's working at all. Okay, power's on. And it plays. Now to clean up that battery compartment. I like to scrape to get the worst of it off, and then we'll go in there with some vinegar. Now white vinegar and scraping to continue chipping away. I like to constantly clean off the vinegar with isopropyl alcohol. Looking better, let's get that door off. I like to clean what I can see, even if it won't directly impact the connectivity. Getting in the hinge is pretty important, since we know a lot of the mechanisms rely on good contact there for connectivity. Unfortunately, this copper tongue doesn't look so great, but we'll do what we can. Not pretty, but a lot better than before. Let's see if there's any improvement. Hey, power. That's better than nothing. Let's try a disc. Looks good. Let's see if that battery gauge fills up. Yep, looks like it went from flashing and empty to 2 to 3 bars. Looking much better. We may need to add a bit of copper. Let's clean up this mess first. We're just going to do a mini service, not a full teardown. Not too bad in there. Just cleaning a little dust and lint with an alcohol-soaked cotton swab. Now a bit of white lithium grease to lube the gear shaft and rail. I like models like this one where it's easy to see and reach the gear shaft without a full teardown. Here I'm just getting the top sled rail that the laser sled moves back and forth on. Back to the other side of the gear shaft. When I power it on, the assembly will move back to the center, working the lube into the gear shaft. I'll wipe off excess lithium grease with isopropyl alcohol. Let's clean off that excess lithium grease. Just 2 screws on this side. Make sure the MD tray is hooked in properly before screwing the lid on. Here, we need to make an adjustment. Once that's in the right place, we can push the lid down and fasten it. Now for the battery door. Let's check out the sidecar. A bit of corrosion, so let's clean it. Let's test. Wonder if the battery's dead. Let's try a different AA. There we go. I haven't tested the output yet, so let's do that. Remote and sound are working fine. All the functions are working. I love these angular, sharp remotes. I'm used to using them in the dark, unlike some of the imprecise Sony jog lever ones. Let's test some recording. This Sony mic came with it, and it partially blocks the remote slot, so let me just put the headphones in directly. Okay, starting over, let's press record to start. You can change the record level, so let's bump it up a bit for these little mics. Press play to start the recording. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Okay, writing. Let's see if we can make it through the talk edit. Nice. The disc didn't get blanked. Let's find our track. Yep, that's my voice. We've got a fully functioning Sharp MD-DR7. It's a bit battle damaged, but it's working great and sounds great. The MD-DR7 is a special recorder for me since it was a highly coveted one that I couldn't get when I was younger. I have working ones now in blue, pink, and silver. I love these things, and I could sell it, but I think I'm going to give away this complete set. Stay tuned for the next MD giveaway. As always, thanks for watching.